Welcome to Rusty Crumpets. Today's Rusty Crumpet is a 1959 MG MGA. This is the sister car to the 1960 MGA featured in a previous video. Now, I'm having a real tough time deciding what to do with this car. Now, I'm not going to scrap it, but I don't know if I'm going to restore it either. It got hit in the right front, right behind the front wheel there. And you can see there's some rust on the shroud. And it's in pieces. There's a lot of little things wrong with this car that make me suspect that it's going to be a tough restoration. You can see the dent down there in the rail, and that's not too bad of a fix, really. That's just sheet metal. So I don't know if the frame is straight or not. It rolls okay. It rolls real easy. It seems to roll straight enough. But that's not really a good indicator on how straight it is. You can see there's rust up on the top of the shroud. I did sand part of it off there. And you can kind of see where the rust ends and the clean metal begins. But it's pitted, so it's going to take quite a bit of priming and some really good sanding to get that smoothed out. And there's a shot of the front. You can see that there is some filler in there. There's some dents in there. Definitely had a fender bender in the front, too, unfortunately. So, again, more problems. Now, the hood was sandblasted, and they were pretty rough with it, so I don't even think I would use this particular bonnet. I've got a stack of other bonnets I've saved that are a lot better than this. This one's really, really rough. There's a bucket full of carb parts off the motor, and that came with it. And over here you can see a little better shot of the dent in the front shroud, and there's a tear right there, that little area of light, that front apron is torn, and the whole thing's wrinkled. So somebody tried to pound out part of this the way it appears. And we'll see in the other corner that there's actually a little bit of Bondo left in it. Here's the corner I cleaned off, and you can see that's dented pretty good. And we'll come around the side here. And we'll open up the bonnet, and the motor is not in this one. The transmission's still in there. Somebody did this. I didn't take any of this apart, so somebody did try and work on it, took the engine out, have no idea why. And there is some wrinkling on the inside fender wells from the impact. So again, I think this shroud, you know, would be a labor of love if you really wanted to restore it, but I think it would be extremely time-consuming to get that straight again. So I'm planning on just taking the shell off, and I've got a really clean front shroud that you saw in the previous video, and that one might go on here, it might not, I don't know, it'll depend on how good the frame is. And you can see the hood's not attached. I can wiggle it around pretty well. And it's unfortunate with that bonnet. They hit it so hard with the sandblasting material, but it really, really messed it up. You can see it's even a different color than the other metal. It's been pitted so bad. And here's what it looked like when I got it. I didn't touch any part of this. There's filler, there's primer, there's rust. And that's what the other side looked like, so I just took the sander to it to see if it would clean up. And for the most part, again, the metal itself did clean up, so it's just a matter if you want to take the dents out. Here's another dent in the rail here, and this fender was not hit, so I don't know if that fender was replaced or what happened there. Again, I'll have to take it off and take a closer look at it. And there's some bits and pieces. There's a luggage rack in there, you got a radiator, you got some seats, got some bits and pieces. Now I like the steering wheel on this. This is the first time I've had a solid steering wheel on an MGA. All the others have been spoked. I'm assuming this is original to it. I honestly don't know because I've never had one with that wheel, but I really like that steering wheel. I do have the metal dash apart somewhere. Somebody had taken it apart. They sandblasted that too, so that was pretty screwed up too. If you're going to sandblast stuff, people, you know, be careful with it, because you, especially on that aluminum, you can mess it up. There's a 50-year-old plus skinny wheel. You can see they still hold air amazingly. Most of these parts, though, you can see they're really rough. A guy's going to have to start over on them pretty much from scratch, find a couple of parts cars, order a lot of new parts. So I really don't know. Send me what you think. Let me know your comments if I should restore it. I might just sell it and let somebody else have it. You can see it's dented down there on the bottom. So it had rear impact, too. I was kind of wondering maybe if this was a race car, if I take it apart and see signs of a roll cage or something in there. I don't know. It's kind of bent up everywhere on it. Anyway, thanks for watching this Rusty Crumpets video. Check us out in the future. I'm going to be going to an auction here in a couple of weeks with a bunch of old cars. I'm going to try and get a video up of that. And send me your thoughts. If there's something else you want to see, we'll do our best to get it up. Thanks for watching. Hope you have a good day. Rusty Crumpets.